Welcome to Reach the World's 2020 Celebration of Learning. My name is Heather Halstead, and I'm the founder and executive director of Reach the World. 22 years ago, I set out to sail around the globe as a young woman and to connect that journey through the internet to students and teachers in classrooms around the United States. That was Reach the World's very first adventure, and we have been having adventures together ever since. This year, 2020, is an incredible year to celebrate the explorer spirit that we all share. So on behalf of the Reach the World Board of Directors and staff, congratulations to you, our students and teachers, on an incredible, exceptional year of exploration, even despite tremendous challenges. My message would not be complete without thanking the incredible supporters who have made our journey possible this year. City E for Education, the Elba Foundation, the Endeavor Foundation, and ICAP Charity Day are just a few of the sponsors whose tremendous support has enabled all of us to continue to explore our beautiful world together and generate the explorer spirit even in the face of adversity. Are you ready for the celebration of learning? I am. I can't wait. Let's go.
And I am studying elephant behavior.
There's food and art and history just throughout Italy.
I'm sharing to you the sunshine here in Rosso, Dominica.
Just getting to the Lost Forest takes about, I would give 10 days.
My name's Eleanor and I'm a wildlife biologist from the UK. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit this morning about how we monitor wildlife in this big green wall.
My name is Fabien Cousteau. I'm a third generation ocean explorer. I'm an aquanaut too, and I don't know if you know what an aquanaut is. It's like an astronaut underwater.
So what sea turtle do you work with the most, and what is a fun fact about that sea turtle?
How do you connect with your friends and family? Because I don't think there's any Wi-Fi in Antarctica.
So my question is, what happens if there is like a sloth or an animal in the tree?
How is being able to work with your team an important factor in the success of the expedition?
Nice, good question, Elliot.
Have you ever discovered a new species you would never have discovered if you weren't a marine biologist?
Yeah, I just wanted to say I've always wanted to become an astronaut, but my stomach wouldn't be too happy with that. I wanted to ask, would you encourage someone to become an astrobiologist, and what steps would they need to take in order to become one?
That's a great question, Jean-Paul.
I'm going to open it up to the classroom to say one final goodbye.
Such
Thanks
a pleasure.
You
Thank you for having us. We really
Bye.
Enjoyed it.
Bye.
Thanks.
Bye. Have a nice day. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Also, remember to stay at home, everyone.
Hello, travelers. Wow, that was a great look back at our year together. My name is Tim, and I hope you're so proud of what you've accomplished this year. You've seen the world through the eyes of your Reach the World travelers and explorers. Let's keep this celebration going with a special message from your favorite Antarctic explorer.
Welcome, Reach the World students, and congratulations on another really successful school year. My name is Holly, and I am lucky enough to have been to some of the most beautiful and remote places in the world. exploring and expanding my knowledge and experiences. And I was lucky enough to connect with some of you guys as a Reach the World traveler whilst I was in Antarctica on the Weddell Sea Expedition. What makes an explorer or a global citizen is not necessarily somebody who's been to the most challenging or harshest environments. Becoming a global citizen is about learning to adapt, to face challenges, to face uncertainty, and overcoming those. And that's something that everybody has done in this challenging year. So congratulations to you all. And I really wish that you have another fantastic school year.
Thank you, Holly. We're looking forward to many more adventures with you. Now, let's hear from a standout Reach the World educator and one of her students in New York City.
Hi, my name is Dina Shmuel, and I work in Flushing, Queens. Reach the World allowed me to connect the world to my virtual classroom. My students study travelers' journeys in different parts of the world, such as El Salvador and France. My students were invited to join live broadcasts and have question and answers session right after the traveler's presentation. Reach the World is able to support educators, students, and families during the remote learning transition. They were able to bring science, exploration, and adventure into my classroom through virtual speakers and virtual field trips. My students traveled the world and learned about different cultures and countries right in their own home.
Hello, my name is Lysandra from 7th grade, and I participated in the Titanic and Oceanfinity launch Zoom meeting call. Both were an educational and great learning experience since I was able to learn about these expeditions that were taking place all over the world. During online school, this was especially important since I was able to expand my knowledge. Not only this, but I was able to learn about these expeditions by people who experienced them upfront. I would love to have these Zoom meeting calls again in the future.
Thank you so much, Dina and Lysandra. To all the students like Lysandra who are joining us today, let me ask you, which Reach the World traveler inspired you and your classmates this year? There were 240 volunteer travelers to choose from, each representing a different global experience. To speak on behalf of our traveler community, I'm excited to welcome Benjamin A. Gilman International Scholarship recipient, Ryan Hobson, followed by Michelle Pickard, the director of the Gilman International Scholarship Program.
My name is Ryan Hobson, and I'm a computer engineer going to school at Mississippi State University. And this past year, I took the chance to travel abroad in France, and it was a wonderful experience. I was glad to be a Reach the World traveler, get to teaching you kids. My class was a second grade class in Queens, New York, and then they made me open my eyes to so many new experiences. They got to teach me about, like, okay, what's your new favorite candy? I had to go find my new favorite candy to show them. And I had to look at new things and a new perspective that it would just make my experience so much more colorful. And so going in with that, that made me take so many things home and telling my family, like, hey, there's so many ways we can do things. We don't have to stick to one thing. And so I was like, okay, I want everyone to study abroad. I want everyone to see new countries and not only learn them inside the books, which is great. And I just want to say to the future students out there, keep learning, keep striving to do your best. Education is really the best thing in this world for you to change the world. That's what you really want to do. And I want to leave you with this quote that I really like. Education is not the filling of a pail, but it's a lightning of a fire. And with that, just go out there and do your best. Thank you.
Hello. It's great to be here for the Reach the World Celebration of Learning virtual event, which celebrates the accomplishments of the entire Reach the World community. Hi, I'm Michelle Pickard. I'm the director of the Gilman International Scholarship Program. We're so glad to partner with Reach the World, an organization that enables Gilman scholars and other travelers to serve as international ambassadors in the form of being a Reach the World traveler and correspondent. I want to thank the nearly 70 Gilman scholars in the U.S. and around the world who volunteered with Reach the World during the 2019-2020 academic year. Boy, was it a year. You shared your personal experiences with K-12 students via the incredible virtual exchanges that Reach the World provides. You inspired American students to pursue their own study abroad experiences, study foreign language, and even think about careers that have an international focus. You modeled what it means to be curious, confident, and compassionate with people beyond our borders. Despite the COVID-19 pandemic, Reach the World educators, students, and families continued their global journeys thanks to the enthusiasm and the commitment of the Gowan Scholar volunteer travels around the world. Congratulations again to the incredible Reach the World organization and everyone involved in the learning community.
Thank you, Ryan and Michelle. And thank you to all the volunteer travelers who amplified their experiences abroad this year by sharing them with a Reach the World classroom. You've inspired us all. Before we get to our keynote address, let's hear from a Reach the World educator who is doing great things in Nebraska.
Hi, I'm Kelly Garcia. I teach Spanish at ESU 5 in Beatrice, Nebraska. And I think global engagement is important for my students because it opens the door to spark an interest in other cultures and other places. And in isolated communities, there's very little diversity in most cases, and they don't have a chance to do that without technology. That's why Zoom is so important. And Reach the World helps with this because it brings opportunities to my students, and I appreciate it so much. It gives different perspectives for my students to think about. And instead of it being a situation of us and them, they find common ground, and then it's we after that. It's, oh, we're teenagers and we have this in common. They're teachers, they have this in common. So it just gives our kids a chance to see how the world really works. So nobody can say, oh, everybody from this culture is like this. Well, that's not true, because I've spoken to people from that culture. They'll have that background and that experience, and nobody can take that away from them.
Thank you so much, Kelly, and hello, travelers. We've gone on some tremendous journeys together this year, and it's especially fitting to conclude this celebration of learning by connecting with a guest at the very heart of the Explorer community. Richard Wiese is the host of the TV show Born to Explore on PBS, and he's also the president of the prestigious Explorers Club. He's joining us today to share some words of wisdom with you as you progress on the path to global citizenship. And because this celebration is all about you, the students, I'm going to turn things over to Dana in Brooklyn to do the honors.
I'm excited to introduce Richard Wiese, the host of the PBS show Born to Explore and the president of the Explorers Club.
Hi, my name is Richard Wiese. I'm president of the Explorers Club, and I'd like to congratulate you on your graduation from Reach the World. I have to admit, I never thought growing up that I would give a commencement speech. And if you would have asked me if I would give a speech remotely, I would have not even known what you meant at that time. But one of the first rules of being an explorer is that a good explorer can adapt to changing conditions. And certainly with all that's going on in the world today between the global pandemic and the cry for racial equality, there's a lot of things that are evolving. Although it's many years, I remember growing up as a kid and seeing astronauts walk on the moon or famous oceanographers, and it just seemed worlds away. I knew I wanted to do more, but it was so frustrating because I didn't know how to move forward. So I'm going to offer you a few tips that worked in my life. Hopefully you could apply it to your life. But remember, not all sizes fit one person. And so what do I mean by that? Take the aspects of role models that you admire and can apply to yourself and accept that. I might have admired Neil Armstrong for walking on the moon, but I was never going to be Neil Armstrong. So pick role models, but pick the aspects of them that fits you. And, you know, at the end of the day, you're going to be the best you can be, not somebody else. As you go through life, you're going to hear a lot about attitude. And so what do they mean about that? You know, for me, it was about being enthusiastic. I felt any shortcomings I had on a skill level or intellectually, I could overcome just by sheer force of will and enthusiasm. And along that idea of being enthusiastic, I would say avoid negative people. You will find plenty of people who say you cannot do it. You know, why even try? It's impossible. I always used to say, just because nobody has doesn't mean I can't. Be enthusiastic, be passionate, use your sheer force of will to overcome things. Character and personal integrity matter. It's easy to be nice and to be kind and to do the right things when things are going well. Character is defined not how we stand on top of a mountain holding a flag or in the end zone or any other good situation. Character is defined when things are not going well. You know, ask yourself, character is doing the right thing even though you know you can get away with it or no one's looking. Look, I realize that everyone is human and makes mistakes. The whole idea of character is to learn from those mistakes and to evolve as a person. Thank you for sticking in. And in conclusion, I'd like to say that everybody's life is like a giant book. It's a book with many chapters, and you're not quite sure how that book is going to end. But you know what? You are the author of the book. You choose how you want the chapters to go. I wish you all the best.
Thank you, Richard. And thank you to the many Explorers Club members who have shown us exactly what it means to be an explorer this year. Reach the World students have demonstrated the resilience and passion of explorers in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic, inspiring us all in the process. Students, on behalf of Reach the World and our entire global education community, have a safe and fun summer, and we can't wait to continue this journey together very soon.